Good morning. I am Destiny Biggers.
And I am George Maktoff. Today on the January 31st edition of The Wind News, we will have a feature over the general employment skills class.
As well as the riddle of the week. Due to the high number of students and staff with flu and flu-like symptoms, we will not have school tomorrow to allow students to heal and rest. Everybody needs to get well soon.
UIL competitors need to sign up with their UIL event coach or Mrs. Graham for the Burke UIL meet by Wednesday. The meet will be held February 16th, and it is the last practice meet before district.
Sign-ups for junior high and high school cheerleading tryouts, as well as mascot sign-ups, are continuing through Wednesday. Please see Ms. Mayo in her office for high school cheerleading and mascot tryouts, and see Ms. Tucker in the middle school for junior high signups. Tryouts will be March 8th.
General Employment Skills is the new class in the curriculum, and it teaches students how to prepare for their future.
Here's John Maktoff with more information.
This is John Maktoff covering the new General Employment Skills classes. Why do we install these classes into the curriculum?
We installed this class into the curriculum because we want our students to be successful. I think it goes along with our motto, learners today, leaders tomorrow. We want our students to be able to go out and become successful young men and women in the workforce, whether that be after college or right after high school.
What do you hope your students take away from these classes?
I hope that students can take away the skills necessary to be able to be successful in the workforce, and that they apply themselves and know that whatever they do, they can be successful with, and that they have a head start amongst other people throughout the entire workforce.
This class helped you prepare for the future.
We have learned to write a resume and how to present our presentation for a job interview.
So it basically teaches us how to make resumes and like for job interviews and getting a job.
So it helps you prepare for the future. It teaches you about like tax and stuff. So when you buy a house, like it teaches you how to like balance out your money and stuff.
Is this a class you think we need to continue having?
Yes, because some kids don't know like the certain stuff, so they need to do it for like their proper education.
Yes, because it teaches us life skills and how to be ready for future careers.
Now back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Jonathan. The PTO is sponsoring a donkey basketball tournament that will be held on Saturday, February 23rd in the high school gym. If you are interested in participating, we are looking for a high school team to play. The team consists of 8 players. The cost is $100, meaning each member after signing the waiver would pay $12.50. Teachers are also invited to participate.
The cost to attend the game is $6 in advance and $8 at the door. Age 4 and under are free. There will also be a hamburger bar set up in the cafeteria starting at 6 p.m. for $5 a person.
And now we have a riddle of the week from Mariah.
This is Mariah Gilbert with the question of the week. What flies without wings and cries without eyes?
That's a thinker. Probably a fish.
Is that even a question?
I plead the fifth.
Cumulonimbus clouds.
What does that even mean?
A cloud. Now back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Mariah. With prom coming up quickly, high school girls have an opportunity to borrow a dress for free.
The third annual Cinderella's Closet will be held from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. tomorrow at the First Baptist Church in Holiday. You can check out their inventory and maybe find the perfect gown.
And now with our weekend forecast is Desiree.
The temperatures are warming up as we enter February. Today's high. The teleprompter isn't going. Today's high will be 65 with a low of 54. Tomorrow the temperatures remain about the same with a high of 67, and on Sunday we will reach the 70s with a high of 74. So enjoy the nice weather for this Super Bowl weekend. That's it for your 3-day forecast.
Thanks, Desiree. Next week's Snack Depot worker is Anthony Shelton.
In sports news, after the Varsity Wildcats and Lady Cats have an open night tonight, I'm going to travel to see more on Tuesday. The Lady Cats last district game.
On Monday, the junior high teams will play Electra in their last games of the season.
Archer will host their first powerlifting meet tomorrow.
Here's Sarah Kyle in the sports corner with more about the meet.
Today I have with me freshman powerlifter Maddie Lopez and powerlifting coach Tim Pope. How are y'all today?
Good. How are you?
So coach, this is y'all's first ever meet in Archer City. How are you feeling about that?
I'm real excited about it. It's very special to host your own meet. There's a lot of planning that goes into it. And the kids have been working hard in helping me prepare for it. And the administration has been helping and giving me kind of, Coach Hannah, Mrs. Hannah have run these before. They've been giving me pointers on what to do and how to run a good meet.
Why exactly did you choose now to have your first meet?
Well, we have the ability to now, and we have the people to, and we have enough powerlifters, and we're wanting to host one, and we're wanting to continue to host a meet every year. It helps us, and it also brings people into Archer.
So, Maddie, how are you preparing for tomorrow?
For the past 2 weeks, we've been 3 days a week, 6:45 in the morning at the school, working really hard for Saturday.
Coach, so how have you prepared for this year?
We started back right after Thanksgiving, and what we did is we met Monday through Thursday, like she said, 6:45 in the morning, and we lift. We work on technique first, and once we have the technique down, then we start to add weight.
Okay.
And it's a really cool thing to get to go to a meet. The meets are big, compare them to like a track meet. Everybody's there and they have their events to do, and it lasts a little while, but it's very exciting to see people do it, especially when they have a lot of weight on the bar.
So Maddie, how far do you think you and your team will go this year?
I think we'll go pretty far because we have a lot of strong lifters this year.
Okay, so coach, what does your team need to work on exactly?
A lot of it is just being able to step in the spotlight mm-hmm. and complete the lifts the way that we do in practice. And of course we have special suits that we wear and we have wraps on our knees when we do the squat. And what we just need to be able to do is to break through a barrier and to conquer and lift more than what we've previously done. And that's probably the hardest thing is we get to a number and we just want to lift more than that and try to exceed our own expectations.
So Maddie, what is your strongest event and what events do you need to work on?
I'm really strong in squat and bench, and I really need to work on deadlift so I can get my points up.
Thank you. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thanks, Sarah. The meet will be this Saturday, so good luck to all the powerlifters as well as the basketball teams.
Mrs. Tanya Mooney would like to recognize kindergartner Kenley Getz as the Wildcat of the Week for being sweet to Ken Davis, as is a nice thing to do, Kenley.
That's it for this week's edition of the Wind News.
Have a great day, and remember, learners today,
leaders tomorrow.